Hello everybody, this is Michel Birler. I will show you how to install Biogeme on a Macintosh. The first thing you need to do is to install Python. To do that, you open your favorite browser and you go to the webpage python.org. On this web page, you go to the download menu and you can find here the download for Mac OS that allows you to download the latest version of Python. Today, this is Python 3.11.3. So I click on it. I need to allow the downloads for the website. And once it is downloaded, I can click on it and install it. I have to answer various questions. And then I click install. I need to put the password to allow the access to the disk. And I install the software. Okay, so it looks to be installed. The first thing I need to do, because I will have to use a terminal, is to update the shell profile command here that you see in this menu. So I double click on it and it will launch it and update your shell to make sure you will have access to Python. Good, so now I can close the browser and I will now open a terminal. So to do that, I will go to Applications. Then there is a directory called Utilities, and where you will find the terminal here. So I open the terminal. Let's make it a little bit larger. And I can verify that Python has been installed. It's Python 3 --version. And we see that Python 3.11.3 has been properly installed. Great. Now, when you work with Python, it is highly recommended that you work in a so-called virtual environment. A virtual environment, it is an environment where everything is isolated from the rest. So you have all the versions of the package that you need, and they don't interfere with the rest of your installation. So in order to create a virtual environment, you simply type virtual env. And then you give it a name. In this case, I will call it my env, but of course, you can call it the way you like. So the virtual environment has been created. And now if we want to use it, we need to activate it. To do that, we type source, the name of the environment, my env in this case, bin, and then activate. And we run it. And we see that it has been activated because the name of my environment is mentioned now in front of the prompt, which means that now I am located in my current environment and I'm isolated from the rest of the installation. Great. So now I'm ready to install Biogeme. And to do that, I will type PIP. PIP is the name of the software that is used to install and manage Python packages. As you can see, it has been installed with the virtual environment when it was created. So I type PIP install and then Biogeme. And now PIP is actually downloading and installing all the packages that Biogeme needs in order to run properly. This includes packages like NumPy or Panda, for example. Now it seems that everything has been installed correctly. And in order to check that, we will need to run it into a development environment. There are many development environments available in the internet, but one of them is provided with Python. It's called IDLE. And as you can see, there is the IDLE icon here, but I will need to launch IDLE from my own environment to make sure that I stay in my environment. To do so, I need to type Python 3 minus M IDLELIB for dot IDLE. And this launches what is called a shell where you can run Python commands. So let's see if Biogeme has been well installed. To do that, we will simply import the module which is managing the version of the package, and we will print the version to see if it works. So from biogeme.version, we will import the function getText, which is the function that is used to report the version of the software. And now I can print whatever this function is generating. And I obtain exactly what I expect, so Biogeme 3.2.11 with some information about the software itself. Great! So it seems that the Biogeme has been properly installed in my virtual environment, and I'm ready to develop nice models with it. Okay, I hope this video has been useful. See you later. Bye bye.